Deep in the deserts that straddle Ethiopia and Kenya, hundreds of fighters are preparing for a hidden war. These are men and women of the Oromo Liberation Army. The OLA says its people, the Oromo, have been oppressed for more than a century. This is an old armed struggle, but many of the people here that you can see were not born when the Oromo Liberation Army was first formed in the 1970s. Today, as Ethiopia faces many conflicts and challenges, this group sees new opportunities.
Oso wareegama guddaan hin bayin akkaatuma itti yaane guutuma guututti Oromiyaa itti dhuunfannu keessatti hojjetaa jirra kanas itti milkaa jirra Finfinneenis marfama keenya keessa jirti.
We cannot independently verify the OLA's claims, but if true, they would have been unthinkable just 12 months ago. Ethiopia's new government is under immense pressure. In the north, Tigrayan rebels are fighting government forces and their allies. In recent months, this war has spread to the neighboring regions, while elsewhere, ethnic conflicts are simmering. And in Oromia, violent protests have rocked parts of the region. And the OLA has waged its guerrilla war for the right to choose independence. The government's response has been tough. In this video, shared on social media, two young men are marched into the bush, allegedly by the police. Human rights groups have accused authorities of indiscriminate killings and mass arrests. The government told the BBC it does not target civilians. In neighboring Kenya, we find families who fled their homes.
Even here in Kenya, you can still see the consequences of the conflict that's happening just across the border over there in Ethiopia. These families came here because they say government forces threatened them. They've been here for about 4 months now, and they say they're struggling to find basic things like food, water, and crucially, medicine as well. We've just been told that a seven-year-old died here a week ago because the family couldn't find help.
We join the OLA in the desert, where their young recruits are learning to live and fight.
A lot of young people here are disaffected with the government, and with so many politicians and opposition leaders currently in detention, a lot of them are seeing this as the solution.
Yes, la aknam toko jirachule mbarbada barachule mbarbada free thay jirachule mbarbada. Garu yo free thay o ham barade savi anke jiru fi umati Oromo guthuni achu chaf sami chafa jecha jal jiru ham garbum ma basha jal jiru yo thate unni ani nyade du guf parnotile na timi jawan thate fi.
But the OLA has also been accused of atrocities. These images were given to us by Amhara activists. They claim they show the gruesome aftermath of an OLA massacre.
The Oromo Liberation Army wants to ethnically cleanse the non-Oromos, especially Amharas, from the Oromia region, depose Prime Minister Abiy Ahmed and establish an Oromia state under their leadership.
The rebels have denied killing civilians and say they would welcome independent investigations. As the day draws to a close, the sounds of whistles and gunfire are replaced with traditional songs about Oromia. Ethiopia is an increasingly fractured nation. All groups involved in its countless conflicts stand accused of gross human rights violations. All deny they're the ones to blame. But what's certain is that it's ordinary people who are suffering, and that seems unlikely to end anytime soon. Yeah.